Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us to given this opportunity for us to carry on our class. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we make dua to Allah. May Allah bless us in the month of Rajab and also bless us in the month of Sha'ban insyaAllah. And may Allah send us sampaikan maksudnya in English. Grant us to be in the month of Ramadan insyaAllah. Amin rabbal alamin. Okay, we will proceed with our Arabic. I think we are at one of the last few pages. Okay, I think all this we have already discussed about how dhamir mutasil, the versatility of dhamir mutasil, it can also connect with harfu jar. And for the last session, did we touch on inna? Did we touch on inna? We did, eh? Yeah. Inna is harfu taukid. Then we also touch on zaraf, such as khalfa here, which means behind. Then we have also elaborate further on how it can be applied in your conversation. So now for the new topic, we will proceed on understanding verbs. I think I did send on the WhatsApp the file. Actually that's the file that supposed to be printed and be bind as a book lah. But because I just finish up the part 2. So yalah, but still we going to discuss about on the part 2 tonight also insyaAllah. Okay, the content on understanding verbs. Again, now we are entering into verbs. Okay, previously we discussed on the part of dhamir, isim. That is very straightforward. Verbs, okay, my advice is you have to pay a bit more attention on verbs. Because again, going back to the basis that 70% of Arabic language comes from tasrif, from verbs itself, the exchangeables of verbs. So we have the thing about verbs, the approach for you to learn verb is that you need to understand the patterns, because the patterns, it can be fixed, it can be variable. It's like learning maths. So bear with me, because learning verb is very interesting. Actually, learning verb is what tasrif is actually one of my subject that I love the most. You want to talk about grammar, you want to talk about Arabic literature. Actually, sorof or tasrif, tasrifat is a subject that I love the most. It's not about, because it has many dimension to tasrif. This is just the beginning stage of learning tasrif. But when you learn advanced tasrif, you will notice how beautiful this knowledge on this subject on tasrif itself. So on the beginning stage, yes, you have to try to acquire this skill set first. So when learning fi'il or verbs, we should start to learn from 3-letter verb. Okay, this is a guideline. Because just to show you, when we say about 3-letter verb, okay, we start with 3-letter verb. Okay, 3-letter verb, always it has to start with fa'ala. This is the wazan, or we can say as an equation that you start with. Wazan, equation, formula, you know, you can name it. All kind of terms, but we always start with fa'ala. This is the 3-letter verb. When we talk about 4-letter verb, okay, this is just showing the overview. I'm not teaching you this today, but I'm just showing the overview how much, right, for you, or how far are you right now, right, and where should we start. Okay, so fa'ala, 3-letter verb. Okay, in fact 3-letter verb, we have fa'ala, we have fa'ila, we have three different wazan or equation, and we have fa'ula. So we have 1, 2, and 3. For four letter verb, we have fa'ala. You don't need to write this, if you don't want to, right? Because it's just a reference. Then we have, for four letter verb, we have af'ala. Then another equation is we have fa'ala. You notice there's a difference in pattern, right? If you notice appropriately, right? There's a difference in pattern. Then, okay, we move to, and then we have fa'lala. Fa'lala. This is also four letter verb. Then we move to five letter verb. Okay, five letter verb, we have tafa'ala. Tafa'ala. Then we have tafa'ala. Then we have ifta'ala. Okay, ifta'ala. Then we have infa'ala. Infa'ala. Last but not least, we have tafa'lala. Okay, you might find it very how to say that? Intimidating, like how come there's so many wazan, Okay, I will definitely share with you or elaborate why I show you all this. Right? It's not to intimidate you, it's to let you understand and give you have a sense of direction. When you learn Arabic, you know where you should start. You don't go any direction, try to learn from the advanced stage. That's the reason why. Then we move to the six letter verb. Six letter verb, we have istaf'ala. Istaf'ala. Then we have the infa'ala. Okay, like for this case, infa'ala is very rare in terms of usage. Istaf'ala. Okay, and infa'ala. So again, why did I show you all this? See, I'm circling. Why am I showing you 4, 5, 6 letter verb? Because you can't learn 6 letter verb if you don't learn this 3 letter verb. What we are doing now and what we are trying to achieve in our basic Arabic is just learning this number one only. That's all. Okay? Not more, not less. Because why? For this number one, fa'ala form, okay, we have three patterns for this itself. I will explain further on that. So don't try to stress yourself learning all this, because if you don't get this fa'ala form, this number one, right, this number one form right, you will never be able to understand fa'ila, fa'ula, fa'ala, af'ala, and so on. You get what I mean, yeah? So be patient. You want to learn Arabic, yes, but not like this. Learning Arabic is not like get rich scheme quick, you know. Get rich quick scheme like that. No, it's not. It's not. Okay. Learning Arabic, it's all about investing your time. You invest time. You invest your effort slowly, 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 slowly until you reach to a certain age, right? When it mature, then you cash in. But once you cash in with that knowledge, is something that nothing can stop you already. Because again, whoever master all this master Arabic language, honestly I tell you, and it's not difficult, it's achievable. If you ask me, I conduct class on every Wednesday class, like Abang Khalid all, they memorize this. Not to say this, but they make an effort to memorize this. That means it's achievable. If people like them can achieve all this, I think you also the same. So don't be discouraged, don't be intimidated by this. I'm just showing you that it's achievable. Okay? And we do want to Allah SWT, may Allah make it easy for us, inshallah. Okay? So learning fi'il, where should we start? We should start from the three letter verb. So here we have an example, like fa'ala. Now you have daraba. Okay? Fa'ala means he did. Then daraba means he beat. Then we have fataha means he opened. And we have jalasa, he sat. Then we have kharaja, okay, which means he went out. Then we have dakhala, which means he entered. Okay, so this is just an example of verbs. Okay, so when we learn verbs, we have to understand that verb have four different kinds of situation. It can change into four situational pattern. Okay, that's what we see here below. We have fi'il madi. Fi'il madi means past tense. Then we have fi'il mudari', which is present tense. Then we have fi'il amr, which is command form. Then we have fi'il nahi, which is the negation form. Okay, so again, past tense. What does it mean, past tense? Past tense means an action or a verb that has been accomplished, has been act upon. Okay, he sat. That means he sat on the couch 5 minutes ago. So 5 minutes ago, it resembles and shows that that action has been done 5 minutes ago, not currently, not ongoing, and not for future. Okay, so that's you have to understand. So that means we have to go back in learning our own language lah, past tense, present tense. Last time in school we learn English. So now, yeah, try to recap lah. I'm not your English teacher, okay? But I'm just giving you the basic fundamentals of this translation. Then we have fi'il mudari'. Fi'il mudari' is more of the present tense. That is currently now. I am sitting. I am walking. Okay, so that means he's doing it now. Then we have command form. Command form is a form of command. Okay, so we have he said, he is sitting. Then we want to command him to sit. Okay, that means you are the one who want to command. Example, you are A, and you want to tell B to sit down. So you tell B, or you tell Zaid, ya Zaid, ijlis, ya Zaid, and iftah. Example here we have iftah mean open, right? Ya Zaid if'al, do. That means oh Zaid, do it means what? That means you are commanding him to do the action. So if you want to command him to open the door, right, or open the window, you command him in a certain way where ya Zaid iftah albab, open the door. Ya Zaid iftah annafidah, open the window. You get what I mean? So it become a command. It doesn't become have any associatement with time. For fi'il madi and mudari', fi'il madi and mudari' here, okay, present and past tense, it has associatement with time. If example, Zaid, right, fataha Zaid albab, Zaid open the door. Open, that means past tense, right? So that means Zaid opened the door 5 minutes ago. Okay, so it has already been act upon. Then, if example, you want to say it in the form of present tense, so it will be yaftahu Zaid albab, Zaid is opening the door. So again, the application and how you want to use and the interchange and the exchangeable of all this wazan, I will teach you, no worries. This is just a big introduction, okay? I will teach you how it change from past tense, present tense, okay? So this is an overview. Then we have the negation form. So negation form, if you notice here, there's a la here. Lam alif in front. Lataf'an. Lataf'an means don't do. Ya Zaid if'an means what? Do. Do it. Ya Zaid lataf'al. Oh Zaid, do not do it. Do not do it. Same. Iftah lataftah. Iftah means open. Ya Zaid iftah albab. Oh Zaid, open the door. Lataftah annafidah. Do not open the window. So again, why you learn verbs is because of this, for you to converse appropriately. For you to converse how to use the command form when you have to, and when for you to negate right, at that specific moment. Okay, same go to daraba, yadribu, idrib, la tadrib. Idrib, idrib means beat. And so again, all these are just a example. So you can refer here for that beginning and for the for this introduction for you to understand what is all about on verbs. Okay. In fact, you can open up your PDF format. Okay. So first of all, before you want to learn verb, you have to understand, okay, the technicality of verbs itself. The technicality of verbs itself. So when we talk about verb, okay, you have to start from three letter verb. So here we have to fully understand the technical aspect of the three letter verb. Fully understand. It's not just passing through. It's not just, oh, I heard of it before. No, you have to fully understand. Like how you understand the format of domir, ana, nahnu, anti, antuma, antunna. Then the domir munfasil, domir muttasil. So it's like how you understand that format, the same. You should put all your effort in understanding verb in this very beginning stage, especially the three letter verb. Okay, you have to start from the past tense. Okay, this is also a guideline for you. So when you want to learn verb one day, okay, you want to learn verb outside, or want to learn verb from another institute, or want to learn verb on your own, you think, okay, you want to go online and check for courses. Suddenly when you check for courses, the first thing they teach you is six letter verb. And not just six letter verb they teach you on present tense. So ask yourself, is that appropriate for you? Is that something that we would say beneficial for you? Definitely not, because why? You have not yet learned three letter verb, 4, 5, 6. So that is going to be issue. So always ask yourself, reason towards yourself, right? And must be honest lah. Because when you learn Arabic, you have to be honest with yourself. Not say, oh, I can learn, no worries, six letter verb. Even though I haven't learned three letter verb, I can definitely understand six letter verb. It's not that I'm undermining your intelligence, no. But go step by step, you will learn better. When you go step by step with guidelines, because this guideline is not given by me, it's guideline given by our scholars. Scholars, when they learn, right, they also learn, but with this guideline, they start with 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? So, except for the Arabic scholars, because all these are really in them, right? So, okay. So, we take from fa'ala form as a reference wazan. Okay, I will underline here, reference wazan. Okay, reference wazan here. You might ask, what is reference wazan? Okay. Reference wazan means whatever we discuss on the topic of tasrif or sorof, anything that have the verb to be exchangeable, okay, we will take fa'ala, fa'ain lam form as a reference wazan, reference equation. It's like, just a bit, just to show you. Example, you know, I'm not good at algebra, you know, like x 1 plus times y 1, you know. Example, I think here some of you all are university students, I think you are way better than me. So example, so you take this as what? You take this x 1 times y 1 as what? As a reference equation, right? Then in when you come across x is equivalent to 10, y is equivalent to 5, example, you know. So you use that as a reference, x 1 times y 1, example. Okay, so it's the same, go for fa'ala. When you come across other verbs, you counter check it, you counter reference it with fa'ain lam. I will explain further. Okay? So wazan means form or equation. Other than fa'ala, it is called mauzun. So okay, fa'ala is called wazan. Fa'ala, fa'ain lam, okay, fa'ain lam, fa'ala, this is called wazan. And when we say wazan, is reference wazan. Okay, other than fa'ain lam, if example we have fataha, all these fi'il madi, past tense, creator verbs and fi'il madi, which is past tense. Fataha, we have daraba, and so on. All these are called mauzun. These are called mauzun. Mauzun is measured forms. You can get what I mean? Okay. In Malay, I talk a bit in Malay so you all can understand. And some of you maybe, if I myself also in English also, I think very hard for me to understand. Okay. So reference wazan in Malay is called wazan rujukan. Okay. Mauzun in Malay, yang dirujuknya. Can you understand? Yang dirujuknya. So that means every reference, there's always a place for you to rujuk. I mean, for every mauzun, there's always a reference for you to go back to it, right? When for every reference that you go back to it is called yang dirujuknya. Understand? Example here, okay. Never mind. We will go step by step. We go very slow, okay. Tonight, don't worry. I will not go like a bullet train. Slowly, okay. The main objective here for us to understand this beginning part. If you think that you need more elaboration or more explanation, please, okay, stop me. I will elaborate further. Okay? I don't mind repeating it again. So here example, we have fa'ala. Fa'ala means he did. The translation means he did. But now it becomes the reference wazan. So reference wazan, you have to understand, for three letter verb is divided into three letters. Okay, if you see here, there's a dotted line, right? It's divided into three letters, and these three letters have a specific and measured term for it. Okay, so like the first letter, so this is called, we call it as the first letter. The first letter is called fa fi'il. Fa fi'il. Okay, what is fa fi'il? Fa means the huruf fa. Fi'il means the position of this three letter verb. That first position belongs to fa. Simple as that. You just put as that, okay? For the second position, we have ain. This ain is called ain fi'il. Ain fi'il. Okay? Then for the third position, we have the lam fi'il. Okay, memorize this. Okay, go back, memorize, you know, fa fi'il, ain fi'il, lam fi'il. Okay, it's going to be very useful, because why? Even you go up to six letter verb, you still will apply this fundamental. Trust me, if you think, oh, I'm going to learn this only in basic Arabic, no. If you go in advanced Arabic, this fa, ain, lam will stay with you forever. You have to bring it together with you. That means it has to be in your pocket wherever you go. So when you learn Arabic, this is the fundamentals you have to build into you. Okay? So understand, huh? Okay. Maybe you ask, how am I going to apply this to other fi'il, right? So now we already refer fa'ala as the reference wazan. So now let us look into other than fa'ala, because fa'ala as a reference wazan is only one entity only. Other than fa'ala, there's millions of verbs, right? There's hundred thousand of verbs. Right, and all that 100,000 of verbs is called what? Mauzun. So wazan is only what? Fa'ala. Other than fa'ala, if you go into the dictionary, if there's thousands of verbs like he push, he kills, he fight, he swims, he walk, he run, he sneeze, all that is mauzun, except for he did. Understand not? Okay, because this is fixed by our scholars for you to learn, sort of for you to learn tasrifat. So let's look at the mauzun. So mauzun, we have fataha. Fataha, it means he open, right? He open. And have to use he. Eh? You cannot say I. I will explain when we reach to that part. Now, just understand it. Yes, he open. Again, so the first position here, we have fa, right? So this fa is called as fa fi'il, as per what you see here. As per what you see in the fa ain lam, but this fa is counted as fa fi'il. Can you understand? Then we have the second position. This ta is not ta fi'il. This ta is counted as ain fi'il. So if you thought the first position for fa here is referring to the huruf fa itself, wrong. Understand not? Okay, I'm not trying to confuse you. Sooner or later you will get it right. Okay, if you see second position you have ta, right? But what does it resemble? Ain fa'il. Because why? This ain fa'il go back to the reference of fa'ala. Okay, first position, again, before I go to first position, then we have the third position. The third position, we have ha, right? This ha. This ha is called as a reference of lam fi'il. But this lam fi'il is a reference from this lam here. Of course, fa, ain, lam. Ain is the second position, lam is the third position. Understand? So my question is, this fa, does it resemble the fa fi'il here? No, because this fa, right, is just the word of this, is just the huruf of this verb. But this fa fi'il go back to where? Here. Go back to this fa fi'il. Go back to this first position of fa'ala. You get what I mean? Okay, never mind. You go slowly, okay? So you understand, yeah? Okay, we go. There's a lot of example. I will give you more example for you to understand. Now we have do, ro, ba. Okay, solid. No, that there's no contradicting factor here. Okay, we have bot, which is the fa fi'il, first position. Then we have ro, the second position. Then we have ba, the third position. Okay. So dot fa fi'il. Referring to, if I say I draft a fa'ala here, sorry, I think I. Okay, I think okay. Let's say I draft fa ain lam here. Okay, because I don't want to scroll up. Fa ain lam here. So same dotted line. So this is a mirror image right now, you can see. Okay, but fa fi'il, this is referring to this first position, fa fi'il. Ra ain fi'il, it is referring to this ain fi'il from the second position. This ba is lam fi'il, is referring to this lam from the third position. Understand? Okay, this is very critical in learning verb. The first thing you learn and master is this. So that means if I give you any verb, you know which is the fa fi'il, which is the ain fi'il, which is the lam fi'il. Again, can grab that part. Okay. Now you see the real thing come into play. Okay. Sorof of verbs. Sorof means exchange of the verb itself. So we have here dhamair, the pronouns. Okay, huwa, huma, hum is exactly as what we follow by the pump. We will show you the diagram of the pump, but now it's been organized into from according to the pronoun huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, huwa, anta, antuma, antum, anti, antuma, antunna, ana, nahnu. So okay, we go to this first part. Huwa, huwa we have fa'ala, he did, we learn, right? Then we go to huma, we have fa'ala, there's a alif, alif there, aliful mad, so you have to prolong it. Fa'ala, translation, they both did. Then the third one, we have home, right? Here we have fa'alu, fa'alu, see, they all did, can see. Then we have here, we have fa'alat, she did. Again, right, you don't need to worry, how does it change, right? I will go one by one. I'm just showing you right now that this is the changes that you're going to expect. The exchange from fa'ala all the way to the 14 forms. The 14 forms. And we are only talking about past tense only for now. Okay. Then huma, for female, we have fa'alata. Okay, this one, I think there's an error. The ta here, supposed to have a mat. Fa'alata. Okay, there's an error here, typo error. Fa'alata. Yeah, supposed to be like this. Fa'alata. Fa'ain lam ta. Right? The ta is with the mat. Then for the next one, number 6, we have hunna. Okay? Hunna wa fa'alna. They all did for female. Then we have anta. Okay, anta fa'alta. You did for male. Antuma fa'altuma. Antum fa'altum. Okay? I'm just going a bit fast a bit. Anti then fa'alti. Antuma fa'altuma. Antunna fa'altunna. Ana fa'altu. Nahnu fa'alna. Okay? Nun with a mat. Again, no need to be worry. Do not worry. You will definitely go one by one. So that's the reason why we learn at this pace. So slowly you can capture and grasp all the information. Okay. Okay. Now then you see in this diagram. Okay. I think you can see. Yeah. Okay. We have. Okay. For verbs is different for noun from nouns. Eh, for nouns itself. Okay. You start from this is number one, right? For the domir ana, you start it as number one, right? For nouns, ana nahnu anti antuma antuna, right? Okay. For verbs is the other way around. Take note. For verbs is the other way around. The number one where? Here. Fa'ala. That's why we learn from fa'ala first. Number one here, fa'ala. Number two, fa'ala. Number three, fa'alu. And this is in sequence. You have to follow sequence. If you don't follow sequence, later become rojak. You know, your mind cannot be organized. Okay. Number five, okay, this is wrong. Okay, supposed to have a mat. Then we have fa'alata. Then number 6 we have fa'alna. Number 7 fa'alta. Number 8 fa'altuma. Number 9 fa'altum. Number 10 fa'alti. Number 11 fa'altuma. Number 12 fa'altunna. Number 13 fa'altu. Number 14 fa'alna. So it's still 14. It's still 14 wazan. And if you see, the verb is positioned according to the pronoun. Okay, so if I go down here, you mirror. Fa'ala huwa, huma, hum. Okay, you mirror. That means I try to smaller a bit. Okay, from here you can mirror. Right, fa'ala is means huwa. Huwa means he, right? Fa'ala means they both, right? Fa'alu means they all. Then fa'alat means she. Am I right? Then fa'alata means they both for female. Then fa'alna means they all for female. Anta means you, male. Antuma, right? Then fa'altuma, we have you both, male. Okay, then we have fa'altum, you both, you all, male, which is come from antum. Then we have fa'alti, it mirrors anti, and so on. Fa'altuma mirrors antuma, fa'altunna mirrors antunna, fa'altu it mirrors ana, fa'alna it mirrors nahnu. You get what I mean? That's why the first thing you learn is you learn domer first, the position of the domer. It will not change. Keep on following, keep on memorizing the position. It will not change. And when you move to, when you scale up and learn verb, it will not you will not face any difficulties. Because why? You know the position already. And you know every position of this palm diagram, it resembles to whom? First person, second person, or third person? Right. Singular, dual, or plural? Okay, feminine or masculine? You get what I mean? So it will not confuse you. Okay, so far any question? Okay, if you got any question, you can straight away ask. Okay. Then I can move forward. Then we will see why we will understand why the far fail, ain fail come into place. Okay, I'm not trying to move very fast. Okay, I think this part will be the last part for us to discuss a bit. But it's important because now we have the momentum. We discuss on this part. In fact, next lesson we will return back. We will return back. Okay, we will revise back. No need to worry. We will revise back. Make sure everyone get what's the how to apply this verb. Okay. So huruf ziyadah. Now we move into huruf ziyadah. Okay. So huruf ziyadah means additional alphabets. We will learn how to apply it in verbs. So this huruf ziyadah means additional alphabets. This additional alphabets only applicable where? In verbs only. So there's actually 8. Some scholars say 9 because of the ha here, right? So yes, 8. So sa'al tumu niha. So yes, sin, hamza, lam, ta, mim, waw, nun, ya, and this ha is counted as additional. Some scholars doesn't count it. Some scholars do. Input it as the huruf ziyadah. So regardless, okay. So this is you should memorize this. Sa'al tumu niha. So this is the huruf ziyadah. Sin, hamzah, lam, ta, mim, waw, nun, ya, ha. Doesn't have any meaning. Some scholars interpret this into a meaning. Some scholars says that it doesn't have any meaning, but if for the scholars that says that it has a meaning, sa'al tumu is all of you ask. Ni, nun and ya is me. Ha, about it. So some scholars have that kind of wordplay lah. But sa'al tumu is a real verb. Sa'al tumu. Right, it's a real verb. It's a verb. Yeah, it's a verb that means all of you, you all, ask. A-S-K-E-D. Then nunya resembles me. You all ask me. Ha, this ha here, this whole ha here, means about it. So, what does it resembles? Wallahu alam. Yeah, so the scholars, they like to have wordplay. Some of them they purposely have this kind of wordplay for you to memorize. Easy for you to memorize. If I will say okay, next session I hope all of you memorize sa'al tumu niha. So you all go back, it's going to be very difficult for you to memorize sa'al tumu niha, right? But for this case, it's going to be quite straightforward. So huruf ziyadah is applicable in verbs. Verb from past, present and command forms. Regardless. Okay. Madi, mudare', amr and even negation form also. Okay. Some scholars said negation form. But for this here, I just put these three forms. Past, present and command form. You will learn the details on the next page. Okay. So here, alright. If you see, it's like playing maths already. That's the reason why we learn the fa fa'il, ain fa'il, lam fa'il. Okay, we take example. Fa fa'il, ain fa'il, lam fa'il. That means here, it means he did, right? That means the domain of huwa. Sorry, domain of huwa. Okay, so this is the fa fa'il, ain fa'il, lam fa'il. Fair enough. So, I purposely input another fa'il here, which is daraba. Daraba means he beat, right? So dot is the fa fa'il, ra is the ain fa'il, ba is the lam fa'il. So this is still the domain of huwa. So it's shed the domain of huwa, right? Okay, then we move to the next phase. If you go to your palm, right, from huwa go up to huma, right? So for huma we have fa'ala. This is huma phase. Am I right to say? So for huma, the reference wazan we have fa'ala, and this fa ain lam still stays, right? Because every verb it has to have fa fa'il, ain fa'il, lam fa'il. Okay, one thing I failed to mention: fa fa'il, ain fa'il, lam fa'il cannot be deducted from the actual verb. Cannot be removed from the actual verb. It has to stay from the actual verb, on the actual verb itself. Cannot be eliminated regardless what is the situation. Okay, this is for your basic understanding. Second, the fa ain lam, let's say example fa ain lam here, cannot be interchanged. Ain cannot be in front, fa cannot be in the middle, lam cannot be in the first position. Understand? You cannot say ala fa, you cannot say la afa, you cannot say la fa'a. If that's the case, it's not the reference wazan anymore. Understand? Same. When you have fixed daraba as the meaning of he beat, daraba, okay? So dot is the fa fa'il, ra is the ain fa'il, ba is the lam fa'il. You cannot interchange. You cannot say ra daraba, ra as the first position, dot second position, no. Or ba as the first position, dot second position, ra as the third position. And ba daro, you cannot interchange according to your own liking. It's fixed. Understand? So this is the reason why we learn the fa fa'il, ain fa'il and the lam fa'il. So moving forward, so now we go to huma. So fa fa'il, okay, ain fa'il, okay, can see. Then we have the lam fa'il. I cancel off. Why I cancel off? Because you want to distinguish what is not the from the original. Original is what? Fa, ain, lam. The remaining here is what? This is the alif. Is the huruf ziyadah. Huruf ziyadah means the additional alphabets. Simple as that. It's like playing maths. Those who are good in maths, you all will be good in this. InsyaAllah. Okay? I love this part lah actually. When explaining about verbs, sort of, this is my favorite part. You can ask the rest who have learned. When it comes to sorof, I love it. Because it helps you to think in a different dimension. Like nahu, grammar, all this, it is good also, but it's very deep. But for this, it really work your mind. Really help you to work your mind and really make you work your mind. So sorof is not for those that thinks, oh, I'm just going to come here, listen, relax. Yeah, it will make you think. That's the best part. Okay, so understand, huh? So this alif is, alif is the huruf ziyadah. Simple as that. Alif here is the huruf ziyadah. Okay, additional additional alphabets. So we go to daraba. Daraba, additional daraba, originally is daraba, right? Now huma, because why? We have to cross reference to the reference wazan. This is the mauzun, right? So you have to cross reference to the reference wazan. So it become daraba. So the same method apply. Dot you cancel off because it's a fa fi'il. Ra you cancel off because it's the ain fi'il. Ba you cancel off because it's the lam fi'il. We have what? Alif. So regardless what verb, you get the same result. Because why? This is derived and you cross check and you cross reference to where? To the reference wazan. That's the reason why this is the reference wazan. Reference wazan. And this is called the mauzun. Mauzun, that means that is being referred. Being referred to. Being referred. I mean, referred to where? It referred to this reference wazan here. Understand? Okay, understand? Regardless, okay, always remember there's only one reference wazan, fa'ala. Cannot be two, cannot be three, cannot be four. There's only one, fa'ala. Okay, when you go up to 4, 5, 6, it's still the same. If you notice just now when I explain about the four, five, six letter verb, okay, you see here. You notice not? Fa'ala, fa'ila, fa'ula, fa'ala, all fa'ilam, all fa'ilam. Do you notice, yeah? All consists of what? Fa'ain and lam, fa'ain and lam. Because this, all this, believe it or not, all this are all reference wazan. So you never go wrong if you learn from the beginning here. You never go wrong here. Step by step, okay? You never go wrong, slowly you go to other reference wazan. There's a lot of reference wazan. You cannot learn all this within one night. Okay, if you can learn this within one night, mashallah, you have at the same level as Imam Syafi'i. Right? Yeah, true. Imam Syafi'i, he can memorize the first page. Sorry, he can memorize, he's reading the first page, but the second page, he already memorized already. By the glance. By the glance, he can memorize the content of the next page. That's how good his memory is. So we pray to Allah, may we get that blessing also lah, insyaallah. If not also, nevermind lah, may 1%, 10% also jadilah. Okay, sorry. So this is just the reference. Okay, we go, we discuss on one more wazan, one more form. So here we have home, similar home, right? The reference wazan, we have fa'alu. So again the same, fa fi'il cancel off, ain fi'il cancel off, lam fi'il, okay, cancel off. But please take note, lam fi'il here has the vowel of the front vowel, dhamma, the dhamma vowel. See ya? Previously is all fathah, right? Fa'ala, then the lam fi'il here is fathah. But when comes to home, the lam is now become dhamma. So take note, this is the pattern. Always understand the pattern. Then this waw is actually sukun. Only that you did not see it. Okay. So other than fa, ain, lam, waw and alif is counted as huruf ziyadah, the additional alphabets. Understand? This is the additional alphabets that is supposed to be in the wazan of home. In the wazan of home. In this wazan. This wazan of home. Just now, huma, what's the additional alphabet? Alif. So, daraba become daraba. Same. So, for home, the additional alphabet has to be waw and alif. Same. If daraba become darabu. Dot fa fi'il, ra ain fi'il, ba lam fi'il, then we have the addition of waw and alif. Understand? It's fixed. You never go wrong. This is fixed. And again, why I tell you fix, go back to the two fundamentals. Fa, ain, lam cannot be eliminated. That's one. Second fundamental is fa, ain, lam cannot be inter-exchange. It's fixed. So the remaining from fa, fa, ain, lam will be the huruf ziyadah to determine the pattern. Okay, understand? So I think our lesson getting more interesting. I hope so lah. Some give me that look like, oh, it's getting more interesting. Some give me that face, or it's like shaking their head. But don't be scared. Even I myself, when I begin to learn all this, right, I feel that fear. I thought that, oh, I it will be very difficult for me, or I will be unable to understand this part of this topic, or maybe advance further. But you just need to repeatedly read up, or just go back and refer to all these notes. Keep on reading all these notes. Keep on viewing. If now we have videos, keep on viewing the video that is being taught on that particular subject. After the 10 times, inshallah, you get it. Say. Huruf ziyadah can be one ayat, two ayat, three ayat. Huruf ziyadah is fixed.
So must be after this three.
Must be after this three. So huruf ziyadah is fixed. Likewise for the fa, ain, lam, okay, that you see here, right? Fa, ain, lam, fa, ain, lam, okay, is fixed. Then we have the alif here as the huruf ziyadah. Then we have do, ro, ba. Then we have alif here as the huruf ziyadah. Because the dot represents the fa, ain, lam. Understand? Fa, ain, lam, fi'il. Same here. Fa'alu. Then we have fa, fi'il, ain, fi'il, lam, fi'il. Then the remaining here, waw, alif, is the huruf ziyadah. It's fixed. You have to go back to the domir. If the domir of whom, it consists of waw and alif. Waw and alif. Okay? Just to show you, okay? Domir of hiya. Now we are at domir of hiya. These are domain of hiya. You see, we have ta with sukun, right? Ta with sukun. So it's fixed. The domain of hiya, the huruf ziyada is ta with sukun. It's fixed. So you don't confuse yourself. Oh, how many words? How many alphabets after fa, fa'in, ain, fa'in, lam, fa'in? No, it's fixed. So when you learn all these 14 now here, inshallah, it's fixed forever. Forever is fixed. You never go wrong. Even you go up to 6-letter verb, you still follow this format. It's fixed. So this is the fundamental. The huruf ziyadah for past tense. I'm just talking about past tense. The huruf ziyadah for past tense. Even you go up to 6-letter verb, you will follow this format. Because the huruf ziyadah for past tense, fi'il madi, only occur at the end of the word itself, at the end of the verb. If you notice, it occur only at the end of the verb, after lam fi'il. So after lam fi'il, whatever huruf ziyadah for the respective domer, right, is fixed. So you just have to keep on memorizing. Speaking about memorizing, okay, my advice. I'm just sharing my advice, and I think I hope you all can do it. Okay, try to go back and memorize all this. Like how you memorize ana, nahnu, anti, antuma, antunna, anta, antuma, antum, hiya, huma, hunna, and huwa, huma, hum. Same. Memorize this. Fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'alat, fa'alata, fa'alna. Fa'alta, fa'altuma, fa'altum, fa'alti, fa'altuma, fa'altunna, fa'altu, fa'alna. Memorize this. You might think, oh, come on, Ustaz, it's going to be is the mission impossible. No. And don't think that way. Okay? If people can do it, right? Other people can do it, so can you. Okay? So have that motivation. Okay? I used to teach this one late uncle. Okay? He's about 70 plus years old. he's been learning Arabic for more than 20 years, longer than me. But yalah, man, I take over Ustaz Anwar, you know, class at his place. So when I start to teach this method, right, he's very amazed. He said, oh, I've never come across this method before. Surprisingly, at the age 70 plus years old, he can memorize, mashallah. So it's a motivation lah. When I look at him, oh, it motivates me. Because why? I have no excuse. I'm also memorizing on other things, you know, in terms of knowledge. So I mean, if he can do it, that means I also can do, or we also can do it. So he set a good role model. So again, it's not about age. It's not about, oh, I'm not good, or I'm not academically inclined. No, there's nothing got to do with academically inclined here. It all boils down to your effort. So how? Okay, you might ask, how am I going to memorize this? You have to repeatedly, right, say it out. First, you open the book, then you open up your palm, right? Then you go individually. Okay, at this individual position. Okay, understand? So when you go up to the palm, okay, you start from where? Huma first. Huma, sorry, you start from Hua, sorry. You start from Hua, Huma, Hum. Hiya, Huma, Hunna, and then you have Anta, Antuma, Antum, Anti, Antuma, Antunna, Ana, Nahnu. So that's a sequence. For verb, for past tense, you have to start from here. So you start from fa'ala, 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 sorry, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'alat, fa'alata, fa'alna, fa'alta, fa'altuma, fa'altum, fa'alti, fa'altuma, fa'altunna, fa'altu, fa'alna. So if this is going to be very difficult for you, open up the e-book, or if you print out, look at the dimension itself. Keep on looking and read, keep on reading, fa'ala, fa'ala, and then point, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu. And after you point on the book, you can point on your palm. Fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu. Last time what I do, I take three at one time. I take one finger at one time. Fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu. You might find it very funny lah, but that's how we memorize it. You know, when I was at Darul Musafa, yeah, I mean, that's how I go to one side, quiet place, sit down like this, right? Yeah, I just fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'alat, fa'alata, fa'alna. No choice, because that's, you have to push yourself in that manner. It's like people from far thought, oh, this guy, mashallah, is doing zikir. But when you come here nearer, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'ala, fa'ala. But when you have intention for zikir, you get the benefit and reward for zikir. You put intention. This fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu is for the sake of Allah. I want to understand Arabic so I can understand the Quran. This is zikir, right? But the zikir of zikir is not the zikir that we always recite lah. But again, have that motivation. And if you ask me, that is our method, and the method that I apply as per advice from our scholars back in Yemen. We go to one side, right? Our scholars say that, okay, you want to memorize something, find a quiet place, then spend, no, you don't need to spend hours. Spend five minutes of your quality time. Sit down, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu. If they say you just want to memorize the first finger, right? So we have 7 days, right? Till next week. 7 days. So we have how many fingers? 5 fingers. So you can have 2 days off. Saturday, Sunday, you can take your off day. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, or in fact today already burn, or start from tomorrow lah. So you can have a Sunday off. Cannot. So one day you target one finger. Fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'ala. You go to work, you go back home. When you are home with your wife, your kids, and when they talk to you, you say fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu. they might find it insane, but no, you are working towards that improvement. Inshallah. Okay, I think we stop here.